Fast Archers are a ranged support class that can provide buffs and healing to your allies, and debuffs to your enemies. Which skills are efficient to use? I spent hours mapping out all of the skill ratios, counting charge for each skill, and breaking down frame data to figure it out. Let's take a look. Note, there are no damage numbers on any of the in-game tooltips, so all of the data that is about to be presented is based on calculations from in-game observation using average value to account for variance, and as such, may not be 100% precise, but should give a good idea of how skills stack up to each other. Additionally, these numbers will be solely G1 values, since it'll be a hot minute before I hit max level and get G3 of all skills, so note that some conclusions may change at endgame. In the following skill comparisons, we'll look at a few values. The skill ratio, that is, the skill's damage ratio from your attack power stat. The charge value, the per second value of each of those. And then a metric that compares the DPS and charge gain value per second of a skill over auto-attacking as well as its cooldown, which represents the total DPS and charge gain value of taking said skill. First is Arrow Rush, your basic attack chain. This is a 4-hit combo, massively backloaded towards the final hit, in both the damage and the charge. This can hit weak points, so manual aiming is preferred. When G3 is unlocked, holding the skill while walking forward will cause you to aim a shot, which deals AoE Earth damage. This cannot hit weak points, but can be good for AoE charging, though it can be awkward to use repeatedly due to having to walk forward to trigger it. Next is your class ability, Cure Arrow. The healing of this is proportional to your intelligence and spirit, and it increases by 50% with level 2 charge and 100% with level 3 charge. Note that the AoE of Cure Arrow lingers for just a second, so if you miss the initial heal, teammates have a second to walk into it to get it. Strike Arrow is a basic shot that could hit weak points. It gives the largest DPS increase over auto-attacking, while generating slightly more charge as well. Stampede Arrow shoots homing missiles that apply a 6-second poison on hit. When locked on, these missiles will go for a single target, though it can be useful to have manual aim in order to hit multiple enemies with a dot. This skill also offers considerable DPS, but is slightly worse at charging than auto attacks. Lethal Shower creates an arrow rain at the select location, dealing damage over time in a large radius. The single target damage of this is worse than basic attacking, but the charge is roughly on par, making it even better against large packs of mobs, as charge scales with the amount of mobs you hit. Hunter Spirit gives you a 10-second buff that increases your charge gain by roughly 9.5 times. Using this in conjunction with AoE charging skills can fully charge your BC gauge very quickly. Groundbreak creates a small AoE on the ground that pulses earth damage 20 times. This has a much longer cooldown than Lethal Shower, but is much more superior in DPS and charge gain, at the cost of being harder to land on multiple enemies. Dust Force is a small AoE that deals 6 hits of damage, strengthening status attribute abnormalities on the target. As of right now, I haven't been able to figure out what exactly this entails. It doesn't increase dot damage, the damage from elemental levels is too small to be able to tell a difference right now, and there's also no change in elemental level application. However, outside of that, It offers slightly lower DPS and charge gain compared to Groundbreak. Hypno Blast shoots an arrow that puts the target to sleep for 30 seconds. This could hit weak points, and it's fairly strong in terms of both damage and charge. And the sleep effect can be really useful to neutralize annoying mobs in dungeons that are separated from your party's AoE. Shockwave shoots an arrow that deals a small amount of AoE damage near it. Only the initial arrow, which is around 2/3 of the damage, can hit weak points. This skill is great for single target DPS, and just average in terms of charge. Healing Arrow creates a small AoE that heals for much more than the base value of the class skill, and also lingers for a few seconds such that allies have time to pick up the heal. Twin Flash shoots an arrow that explodes in a small AoE and deals 0 damage, but applies 2 effects. First, it increases damage taken by the target by roughly 3%, and then it buffs the damage dealt by allies in the vicinity by 10%. Both of these effects last for 10 seconds. Resonance Shots spread some of the elemental gauge on a target to nearby targets, capped at a small amount. Its main use case would be with multiple very tanky enemies to hit that elemental burst faster, though at early game values, the usefulness is questionable. Refresh Area cleanses debuffs on yourself and allies in range. Finally, your ultimate, Mortal Gravity, deals damage on impact and then 17 hits of damage in a large AoE around the impact area while pulling mobs in. None of this damage can hit weak point. Here's an overview of all the skills and their respective data. The notable takeaways are Strike Arrow, Stampede Arrow, and Shockwave are the best choices for single target DPS, and Lethal Shower is a DPS and charge loss in single target scenarios. Force of Hearts, most skills charge around the same fast, though AoE skills are much more effective in charging in any AoE situation. Anyway, I hope this data was helpful in understanding the strengths of the different Blast Archer skills. If you want to look at the data, I have a link to the spreadsheet in the description, which I will keep up to date with new information as it comes. When I get around to endgame, I'll be sure to update you guys with proper builds, G3 alpha and beta analysis, and more deep dive theory crafting. So, I'll see you guys then! Bye-bye!